Hi, I'm Real Genetic Demon, and this is What's on the Tape, Volume 6. Got it right for a change. I've got, out of the box this time, I've picked out two tapes, because this one looks like it's going to be short anyway, because Sony says California Games on that side, and on the other side, and Sir Philip's one, it says Gauntlet 2, which I'm quite looking forward to, actually. I haven't played Gauntlet in years, especially on the Spectrum. I think I might have played it on the Mega Drive. I say in years, I did play it on the Mega Drive, I think, recently. That was Gauntlet 4. And I've also got this one, which is a Contex, I think it is. Audio Gold International. So we're going to give this one a try as well. It hasn't got anything written on it. It's got a bit of Tip-X on the bottom of there. So somebody's changed what was on it originally. So and same with this side. I can't quite see what it is. So we're going to give these a try, see what they're like. We're going to start with, I think, the California Games. But I have a sneaky suspicion, by the way, that there's only one game on there, or one or two games on there at the top, because it came from one particular person who did only seem to record one or two things on a C90. But just in case, and in fact, and we're going to do it anyway, I've actually got Mega Tape 1 from Sinclair User, which has got some kind of Zarjas game, mega game, no idea what that is. Exclusive demo, 19 from Cascade. I wonder if... Cascade, they did that tape, didn't they, with the 50 games on it. I wonder if this is anything like that. Anyway, so we've got these as a backup, and we've got the Banzai Bear. That's his correct name, I believe. We've got Banzai Bear, so we've got Mega Tape 1, and we've also got these ones. So without further ado, I'm going to put that one in the drive. Right, we're in front of the Spectrum, ready to go. We have the one that says California Games in the drive. This was an Epics game, if I remember rightly. Epics with a Y and an X, because that's how you spell Epics, of course. I remember this. I'm going to try the loader, because I think this could multi-load the whole thing in, maybe. Anyway, this is an Epics game. I've played it on the... C64 Mini. I've played it on the Spectrum years ago. I don't remember actually owning a copy. It wasn't a game that really struck me as something I wanted to play. I didn't mind these multi ones, because I did like Decathlon, you know, Daily Thompson's Decathlon, Super Test, and all those kinds of things. Even the Jeff Capes one, that was really cool. I quite enjoyed that one as well. So it's not a game that I haven't tried and used before. This one was a weird one, because it had hacky sacks in it, didn't it? And I think it had BMX riding, and I suppose it was kind of cool in that way, but, excuse me, I'm a bit of a dry throat today, probably talking too much. Can you imagine that, me talking too much? Doesn't happen very often, does it? anyway, no, I remember this being game sort of for those kind of things, cliff diving. Cliff diving was kind of cool, though, because you landed on the bottom and you kind of bonked your head if you dived too far and straight or whatever it was. That was alright, actually. Anyway... There was another one as well. They had Winter Games, didn't they? They had lots of these things. These are all kind of things. Is there an equivalent? Yes, there is, isn't there? Isn't it Sonic at the Olympics? Mario and Sonic at the Olympics. That's the new modern-day equivalent of it, isn't it? But I don't doubt they're joystick wagglers, are they? Don't know. I've not had any. Let me know in the comments below. I have, for my DS, my Nintendo DS, because I also like collecting DS games. I don't know why. I just do. There's billions of them, I think. I think the current count is several billion games. But I quite like the DS. And as a result, I've got a few games, including... Track and Field, which was another one, I don't think it's Hyper Sports, is it? Track and Field, it's a different thing completely, and that's on there, but I've never tried it yet. It's sitting there. I bought a few things. This is the problem with being kind of a collector. I'm not a complete collector, but I am a collector of certain things. I collect Nintendo sort of DS games. I collect Master System games at the moment, and I'm collecting Spectrum games, but I'm after sort of what you call double cassettes at this point in big boxes, because I've had all the rest of them before. Anyway, so I don't collect a great... I collect hardware, though. I have lots of hardware. I love hardware. I think that's one of the things as well. Right. Do we want to do all of the events? Because I don't know whether we'll have to load them here. Should we just do all of the events, and then that saves us going through it? This could take a while. Let's just play all the events. Enter. Caps lock. Number 1. Define controls. 6. Cursor keys. Cursor keys. Spacebar must be enter. Define controls. Define control set 1. Space for fire. Up. down, right, left. That's quite good that that's happened there. So let's play, let's use the cursor key, play all events, demon. So we've got Burton Radmag. What, oh, is this the name of the company? Oh, official a frisbee. I'm guessing these are the events. Epic Software. Select your sponsor. Oh no, select your sponsor. Well, I think we're going to have to go with Epic Software, haven't we? There we go, Epic Software. No second player, so it's just me. One player, yeah, that's correct. This is one of these things about this thing. I remember, yeah, that's correct. Just the single player. Half pipe next event, okay. Press play on the tape, that's good. That makes sense to do it this way, because at least this way we're not trying to skip anything, because it's awfully difficult to skip sections on a tape player. I always found that, you know, it's all right when you have to rewind right to the beginning because you've lost the event or whatever else it is. And it was always very difficult, wasn't it, when the game made you rewind back again. And the problem with, and I'm using a plus 2A again, remember, because my production lines aren't particularly well at the moment, there's no tape counter. Seriously, why wouldn't you have a tape counter on it? I mean, they managed to get it on the Amstrad CPCs, but there's no tape counter on the 128K. Although this particular one, don't think there is on the production line, is there? No, I don't think there is either. It just doesn't make sense, does it? I don't understand that. You know, you've got games that are multi-loaders, but you need a tape drive and you need a list. Anyway, right, any minute now, though, I'm half expecting my wife's daughter to bail through the front door after being out and triumphantly buying knives and forks. Yes, knives and forks. So if I get interrupted, that's why. So I may stop and have a wee interlude for a change in the middle of it all, but I'll be straight back. Anyway, so half pipe it is. This is half pipe. It's the half pipe. It looks like half a pipe. If you cut a pipe in half, it's half a pipe. And this is BMXing, I believe. So this will be interesting. So, got my keys, QA, OP, and space. So do you normally use M? If you've got the original Spectrum, you'd say M. In fact, if you've got a lovely Omni, you can one of the new Spectrums, but they aren't Spectrums. But they are Spectrums because they're like built with Spectrums. Do they have a Spectrum ROM in them? They must have a ROM that's a Spectrum ROM in them. I don't know where that comes from, though. Is it actual officially taken out of an original Spectrum to put it in? Can't be, because you can swap between them all. So it must be a bit of hardware jiggery pokery with a ROM in it somewhere. Anyway, if you know, comments below, please. But yeah, if you got an Omni, they come with a lovely rubber key keyboard. I've got to admit, I really like them in the rubber key keyboard. It's more for me. It's 100% nostalgia than anything else. So I kind of like those. The other thing I've seen recently, and it's not Spectrum, entirely Spectrum related, is I saw a Just CPC issue 2, which is basically a remake of the Amstrad CPC 6128, but it fits into the case of a 464, and it's a modern equivalent, and it's really quite good, actually. I'm quite impressed by the whole thing, to be honest. It looks really good, and I think I might actually do that. And that's my son running up and down the stairs. He's very excited because his mum and sister are out at the moment. So right, so that's me. Okay, I've already fell off. You can't kick turn backwards. Right, okay, that's me kick turning back. No, that's me kick turning there. Turn too long. Right, okay. So go up that. I fell off again. I don't think this is going to go very well. I've got 47 seconds left to perform. Game over. Great. I'm still first, though, because I, of course, am rubbish. Next event, footbag, which is hacky sacks to you and I. And I don't know how this is a sport, really. I mean, it's kind of clever, but I'm not entirely sure how it's a sport. You kind of kick a little ball up in the air. So that was really impressive. You see my skills there on the it was a skateboard, wasn't it? It wasn't BMX. I thought it was a skateboard. It's a skateboard rather than a BMX. But anyway, so footbag is this little sort of sand field, is it? It's sort of bean filled, isn't it? Little beans of some sort that you bounce up and down your feet and you do sort of tricks with. So it's kind of like football, but with a smaller ball, but without the, I don't know, without the bounce of a football. Yeah, I know, it sounds a bit weird, doesn't it? Anyway, so Well, as I talked about the Omni there, I do like the Omni because it's effectively a really good Spectrum, if you know what I mean, and it also emulates a number of things. It's one something I keep meaning to do on my site, my channel, to do a little review of it. If you'd like to see a review of the Omni by me, stick it in the description below. We'll give it a go, all right? If I get enough comments about it, I'll go for it, because it really needs to be done. So it's the one thing that I need to do. Now, this kind of leads me on though too, because the Omni, in my opinion, is a good modern-day clone of the ZX Spectrum. All right, so there are other ones out there. I think there's the Just Specky 128K, and there's a few others out there. The Uno comes to mind as well. I think it's one called an Uno, ZX Uno. I think that's another one. You might think of some more, but again, comments below. The Spectrum itself, right? Okay, so we're in the end of the sort of the 90s, you know. I think it was about 95 that the kind of real death of the Spectrum, in the sense of, you know, production and whatever else is. But we're in that kind of time, and you know you have to move forward with it. So Clive goes off it's already Amstrad, but he's thinking already of the QL back in was it 87 or something similar. The QL is the one he's thinking of. So here we go. I've got a little head. Right, so I've got to kick up the hacky sack. Look, there we go. And then bounce my head on it. That's good. Bounce my head on it. There we go. Bounce my head on it. There we go. Oh, missed it. There, it's on my knee. Off my head, knee. It's amazing I'm managing this so well. I like this. Quite good, actually. It's strange that this one's so simple, but it's got my attention. So we're going with that one. Oh, no, left of the wrong knee. And he's going to hacky sack it in the air. Oh, we missed it. I'm trying to think, is there a way to... Yeah, we got a knee. Oh, missed it. Oh, it's all right, though. Five in a row. Completion's got one. That was all right. We've got the Dizzy Dean, the Headbanger, the Reverse Doda, the Jester, the Doda, the Double Arch, the Horseshoe, Axel Foley. The Full Axel, the Half Axel. Very nice. Anyway, yeah, I enjoyed that one. So... Yeah, so it brings so I was discussing there, those are proper Spectrum clones, and I know there's obviously some Russian ones out there which were clones of the time or whatever else is, but you Sir Clive Sinclair, you've got to the point where you know creating the QL, and I know there was financial difficulties, this, that and the other, and micro drives weren't exactly the hottest idea in the world, but the QL is your business machine. It's way too expensive, and then it drops down in price and whatever else is, and then you're almost competing with the Amiga now. So you know, you're adding sugar, you own the Sinclair rights, but you don't really go any direction. You stick with the CPC 128, and you do the plus version of that. The Spectrum gets a sort of a badge to sort of look a bit more Amstrad-y, but the QL kind of hits the skids. That's it. This QL's disappeared. So nothing fills the gap there beyond sort of, you're into then Atari STs and Commodore Amigas. Now, there's nothing, as far as I'm concerned, there's nothing else in that 16-bit sort of PC range other than PCs themselves. So your Intels and your 386s and your 286s. There's nothing else that fits into that sort of category. So along comes the futurized version of it, and they reinvent the Spectrum, and they call it the ZX Spectrum Next. Now, my query on question, the thing that runs through my mind about the ZX Spectrum Next, is that, is it a Spectrum? Yes, it's what's known as FPGA technology, which basically means a hardware emulation rather than a software emulation, which means you program a chip to look like a ZX Spectrum. It's used very well by the analog team who make the analog Mega. I think it's a Mega Analog or something similar. It's basically a Super Nintendo version of it. There is the Nintendo Entertainment System version and a Mega Drive version at the moment. And then basically they've programmed a chip to emulate the ROM sets and the other functionality of the actual hardware. The resulting effect is absolutely perfect, because it is effectively emulating the original chipset's perfect version of it. So you get a perfect Spectrum on the ZX Spectrum Next.
However, there's another element to it. There's the next element of it. Now, I'm not sure with the fact that it's just an emulator, emulated hardware emulation. I don't know what's happened there, but I'm not sure that with hardware emulation that this thing isn't actually is actually a new version of a Spectrum, because you can change that to fix bugs and things on the fly. I know it's modern day and whatever else it is, but the Spectrum came out of the factory, and if it had a bug, you were pretty much stuffed unless there was some way to get a recall. That was it. So, it, to me, I'm not sure that the Spectrum Next is a new Spectrum. It's maybe what would have happened, but I'm not convinced. And I'm not convinced probably because, as I say, it's not what I would call... It's hardware... But it's with emulation within that hardware. That's very hard to kind of explain. But it's a perfect Spectrum. But what would the next Spectrum have been? Because it's very much... It looks like a Commodore Amiga. And it looks very much like an Atari ST. However, to be fair to it, it's been dreamt up by... I'm going to quit this, by the way. And I'm going to fast forward and see what's on tape as well, by the way. It's been dreamt up by software developers. People who developed for the Spectrum back in the day. So I'm assuming it's a wish list of all the things that they would have liked within the whole thing. I'm just going to do load dit as well, because we're going to see what's there. A wish list of what they would have liked back in, say... 1989, 1990 to 1991, 92. So that's the when the Amiga would have been there, and the Commodore and the Atari ST. Sorry. So this is kind of their wish list for a Spectrum that would have been there. Now, if they're making it really accessible, if they're making program language really accessible, that's great, because that actually brings another generation. Problem is, the price is quite high at the moment. And I know that they're having manufacturing issues, and they've had manufacturing issues for quite some time with the actual case. And I'm quite convinced that because they're very... They talk about what's going on. This is no vaguer accident, if that makes sense. That's another level. It's no vaguer accident as such. It's in progress. I just wonder. I mean, what are your thoughts? I mean, they're using clever modern day chip technology to create the new Spectrum. But does it make it a Spectrum? I mean, the fact that it emulates Spectrum for all the other things, and you can run things at faster speeds. I mean, the other thing here as well is you can put an accelerator card in it. This is an interesting comment as well I'm going to make here about this accelerator card. You can put into it a Raspberry Pi Zero. Now, a Raspberry Pi Zero is a computer in its own right. Does it run at 900 Hz? Which is way more than the original Spectrum. I mean, even with their modified way that they're using effectively a Z80 processor, they're only running at 7 megahertz at any one time. It can run at 900 megahertz. Can the actual accelerator card? So my question in my mind is whether or not it's not as what I would say officially endorsed. Either it's not what I would call an officially endorsed product either. I don't think it is anyway. And there's the doorbell going, because my wife, daughter, and son are all bailing into each other at the front door with the dogs barking. So hang on a second. I'm going to pause my recording and I'll come back to you. Hang on. Okay, I'm back. So right, where were we? We were trying to find out if there's anything else on this California Games tape, and I was having that little. It's not a rant. It's just a thought about these. When the ZX Spectrum Next first came out, I was very tempted to back it. However, at the time, I thought it was prohibitively expensive. I think it was £199 just for the sort of board itself, and then there was nearly £300 for the thing without. Now, to be brutally honest with you, and I'll be brutally honest about this, you can buy a PC for that kind of money, and you can buy a PC that has sort of not the most excellent of things, but you can buy most of the components for a PC. You can buy a Raspberry Pi with more power. In fact, you can buy a Pi 4 now at this point, which is quad core and two digital outputs from it. This, what I'm saying is that you could buy all those things for that. Now, I know that it's a labour of love when you buy something like the ZX Spectrum Next. It is most definitely a labour of love. Without a doubt, the guys involved in it love this product. However, at this point... we're several years down the line, and that's always the way with Kickstarter and similar projects. They always, almost always, never run to time, which is absolutely fine. You should expect that if you back something that's crowdfunded, you should almost expect it not to make its deadline. You often find though that if it fails to make its deadline, one of the exciting things is if it makes certain parts of it, like the C64 Mini, those people who backed which was originally a whole keyboard and whatever else is, they got a mini in the in-between, and they're going to get the keyboard free of charge as well. Well, the keyboard should say version as well. So they got the mini free of charge to go with it also. So they got something out of it. And this is the thing. The crowdfunding things can take a little bit of time like that, but I don't know. I think at the time I might have bought it, but I would have gone for the cased version, which of course I'd still be waiting for at this point in time. The board version, of course, would have been through, which is fine. I think it has some value to the retro community. It's definitely something else. I know that people are developing games for it. That's fine. But your market's limited. It's a very small market of people who currently got it. I know that there's a suggestion of a further run, but I don't know. I'm now less excited about it than I probably was previously. I think I'd like to see more and more available and a cost that doesn't seem to be quite high. I mean, the original Vega, which I actually backed, the original Vega, before all the troubles and all the other bits and pieces, which was one of the early things, and they made mistakes. They should have gone with HDMI for its output for start off instead of the standard AV cables. That was an issue, and the whole lacking an ability to plug a keyboard in to go for the text adventures. There's always like 200 text adventures on it. You try doing text adventures, I'd just try it, look on my channel if you want to see the lack of entertainment that's involved in doing those text adventures with a key. I'm going to swap this over by this tape. I'm more than halfway through and there's no more data, because as I said to you before, this person has a bit of a reputation, the person I got these from, for not actually putting things on. Anyway, but they've made mistakes, and you got your SD card, which you kind of pull out. It isn't sprung loaded. It's a simple thing, but anyway. So there was issues with the original Vega. The Vega Plus I didn't back. I know that apparently there was a roadmap thing included, a handheld version. I wasn't very interested in that. I wanted to play on the telly and relive the sort of my childhood, plug into the television and play Jesse Willy or whatever else was on it, Jetpack. In fact Jetpack works very well on it because of the pad and whatever else. It's certain games, arcade style games, work very well on it, and I'm not gonna knock the early stage of that. I think it got burnt very badly by the Vega Plus, and I think that the behavior of the people involved was disgraceful, but it is what it is. So this should be Gauntlet, by the way. This is what we're going for. But as I say, the ZX Spectrum Next, it's beautiful. I've seen the designs. I don't think I saw it. I don't think I was. I was certainly at a thing in Glasgow not that long ago. But I think they've only come this year. And it was last year. I was in Glasgow at a Play Expo, I think it was. But it looks stunning. I think it's going to be nice. And I think, as I say, is it a curio? It possibly is, because it's down. It's volume and numbers. You have to get it here. Alright, okay, I don't know what it here is, maybe it's Gauntlet. Maybe it's a curio. I don't know. See what you think. I mean, tell me in the comments below. I mean, ZX Spectrum, ZX Spectrum Next, is it what you expected, I think, is the question I'm asking. I'm not sure that it is or it isn't for me now. I think I've lost. It's been diluted with the time anyway. So, but after that long sort of discussion about the ZX Spectrum Next, and I say, the whole thing sounds lovely. It looks lovely. Just, I don't know. I don't know where I stand on it now. I really don't. I think I've lost a bit of focus on where I stand on it. And I mean, I follow the groups that the gentlemen that are involved in it, developers and a few others, and Jim Bagley himself are in. There's a lot of people doing the usual thing, where the hell's my Next, because it hasn't got a cable. But they're getting kept up to date with these things. It's not like they're not. It hasn't got a cable. It hasn't got a case, should I say. Or there's case issues. But they're getting kept up to date. And the games that are being created, brilliant, but as I say, is it it's more like a Commodore Amiga, and I know that Commodore and Spectrum has always been a kind of a bit of a, or Sinclair have been a bit of a, you know, bad match, because you know, you've got the Commodore 64, of course, you know, so, and that would have been a competitor, direct competitor to the Spectrum. But don't know, really don't know, where I stand on this one. It's a tough one.
Tough.
Anyway, so Gauntlet 2, arcade game by Atari, I believe. And this is where you get to play as a wizard, a warrior, an Amazon, and an elf, with their own sort of individual sort of powers and strengths and whatever else it is, and different magics that they can cast. And this is really good because in the arcade, this was a four-player game. You could actually find cabinets with four players on it. I mean, how awesome is that? I can't remember if you can play in the home on four players. I'm not sure you can. I think you can play at least two players. I'm not sure you can play four. It was a game I really liked though as a kid, you know, because it had lots of dungeons and lots of levels, and it was pretty, because it's an arcade game, you knew exactly where you stood. You were kind of disappearing down into the sort of the dungeons, getting deeper and deeper and deeper. And was there 70 or 100 levels to it? Something like that. It was a lot of them. It was a style that was copied quite frequently. I think though this is going to be a tape loader, multi-loader, so we'll see. Got a bit of music going on. Yep, okay. If the tape reaches the end of side 2, rewind to the start of side... Sorry, if the tape ends... End, well, the tape reaches the end of side 2, rewind it to the start of side 2 and press play for more levels. Okay, whatever. Right, character select. Spacebar. I'm going to go with keyboard, which is 1 Q S D and Z for fire and caps for magic. That makes sense. Caps lock, caps shift. So I'm going to press, use the cursor keys to move down. And press space to select it. Oh, there we go. I'm going to be the warrior. Oh, and we've got another one. Have I made a mistake here? No, this could be interesting. I think I've chosen too many characters. I think we've got two player. So this could be bad. We'll see what happens. I don't think I've ever played Gauntlet 2 on the Spectrum. I certainly played the first one. I don't remember 2. I mean, it'd be much of a muchness, I would say. It's going to be hard to rewind this on here, though, because I can't, because obviously it's a what's on the tape. So it's going to be a bit of a tough one to actually do. Lovely. Do you know something? With the low sort of the graphics that are available at the time, I still think that looks like that's a lovely display of characters set up to go. You know, you definitely know what everybody's doing, what the roles are. It looks really good. I think I've made a mistake, though, with the blue. May have to get them to die. You had to eat turkey to keep your energy up. That's the thing. You run around the dungeons, keep collecting turkey and treasure and all the things. Is it purely high score? I mean, if you finished it on the arcade, did it go round again? Did I ever play the arcade game version? I think I did once. I don't think at the time. I was quite young. I remember being quite little when I played it. And I think I wasn't very enamoured by it. It was alright. I think as a kid, I mean, it was better once you got it on the home machines. You know, once you got it to your Spectrum, that was brilliant. You know, that was where you wanted to be. Oh, nope. Start the tape. I'm still starting the tape. Are we loading? Oh, still loading. I thought for a minute there we'd stopped. I thought that was it. Thought we were all ready to go. Almost there, I can feel it. Feel it in my bones. I recently joined a new group on Facebook, Sinclair for Sale. What a mistake that is. I can feel my bank account draining as I act every second that I'm on there. It's certainly adding to my collection. Not been a big collector of particular makes or brands or producers or sort of labels. But I did discover recently that I do seem to have quite a large Hit Squad collection, and I did that's just pure fluke more than anything else, because I had a little tidy of my cassettes the other weekend. God, what a tidy that was. It was exhausting. It was huge piles of things everywhere, and, you know, plenty of duplicates. I think I had over 240 duplicate tapes, which is unbelievable. And probably not quite as many for my Amstrad. I had quite a few for the Amstrad too, but there was quite a lot of tapes that were duplicated. Quite embarrassing, really. Some of them are probably very common as well, and everybody's got about 20 copies of Checkered Flag, don't they? Without a doubt, they have 20 copies of Checkered Flag. You just don't know what to do with them. I mean, it's always the same retro issue. I was talking to Dave Birtle and Andre Russell recently, and I said, what do you do with these things? What do you do with the duplicates? You know, what do you actually, you know, you but and you get the same reply from everybody. It's like they don't make them anymore. You can't bin them. You can't throw them out. You can't throw them away. And I completely understand that. There is no. Let's hope this works. Let's see if this works. There's no getting rid of them. You know, you can't get rid of them. It's almost wrong to do so. You can't throw away a whole load of Checkered Flags just because they're no longer. Just a shame, really, and that's what I mean. It's a real shame. What do you do with them all? Where are you at with them? They're good, but it's tough to do that. Right. Okay. So here we go. So we'll get that. Now there's usually a way to put yourself down levels to the next point. Oh, here we go. So that's a generator there. These things generate the creatures. I love this game. So we can either go down this one, exit one, which will take us down to level two, or we can open this door, which is what I'm going to, and we can skip a couple of levels, and we can go down a bit lower, a bit quicker. And our health's on the side of the screen there. It goes down. I said before, we go down. We can go down another exit. There should be exit four here. In this level area, maybe not. There's some openers, I think, for doors. There we go. I like the way the generators sort of reduce what they do. I mean, as I say, proper arcadey. This is your Dungeons and Dragons kind of thing going on. There we go. Okay, let's see. There, see, exit to level 6. So let's try level 6. Let's go down there instead. Let's not go all the way down further than that.
Oh, damn. Is it level by level?
Oh, I should never thought of that. Mind you, that's kind of cool if it is. A lot of loading, though, for Gauntlet 2. That's a bit of a shame, actually. Maybe it loads it in and says, "Oh, he's gone to level 6. I bet if I'd gotten level two, it wouldn't load it. Yeah, because that's it. So it's find the potion. That's a fire at will. I never know what will's done, but we have to fire at will. Here we go. I don't know why I'm shooting that. I need to shoot that though. Find potion. There's an exit. There, I've got the potion. Ha ha! That's my special. So I push that button there. Boom, everything goes. Ha ha! Right, let's go down to the next level. Level 7. Yeah, so I must do 6 levels at a time in the little load, which is kind of cool. Ooh, got an amulet. That lets me walk through walls. That's kind of cool. It lets me walk through everything. That's not very cool. We're going up here. We're killing. There's the exit. Yeah, go down the exit. Look at those creatures. They're kind of good. Find the potion. Am I still in super mode where I can walk through things? Don't think I am. We'll go through here. If you leave those generators, they absolutely fill the rooms with ghosties and ghoulies and things. Lots and lots of creatures just appear if you just leave these things alone. So it's almost worth killing them, and you can shoot through at an angle through walls, by the way, if you noticed. Look, Boom, boom. I don't know if I want to be in there yet. I'm just collecting keys here like crazy. There's a potion. Oh. Did I shoot the potion? I think I did I? I'm stuck in these guys. Go. There we go. It's a good game, actually. The graphics are cool as well. I mean, you really know what's going on. It's nice when they do that. I mean, I like that kind of thing. Health's really low now. It's kind of a little thing that's counting down there. We need some food. It's basically what we need. See if I can see any food in one of these. Let's go in this one. I've not got much in the way of... Let's grog. Ah, no, poison myself. Oh, no, it's health. It is health. Oh, damn. Didn't realise that. I would have caught checking them before. I thought they weren't health. Oh, it is health. Good. Exit. There's exit. Let's get some health while we're at it then. Get that one. Shoot that. Jump down there. Cool. I always thought they were poison when they had little X's on the bottles. You would have thought they were poison, wouldn't you? Right. Go find a key first. There's a key. Let's open this one because it's got health in it. And something weird. Invincibility, I think. I've got something anyway going on. Something insane. Look at the brightness of these colours, these graphics. And you know what? It's one of those games without the old clash going on. There's not a lot of clash going on here. It's good. Not a lot of clash for a Spectrum. That's kind of cool. Ah, potion. I'm stuck. What happened there? I managed to be in a magic wall of some sort. Ah, no, what you done? I'm not going that way. Ghosties and everything everywhere. There's another key there and there's some food. Let's get the food. Key. Poison. Bit of grog. Is that Monkey Island? Classic game on the spec on the PC. Oh, hello. Oh, the walls move. That's weird. Get out the level up. Yeah, another level done. We're down to another level. We're down to 10?
10.
10, something like that. We'll be next level on this one, anyway. There's no way I'm rewinding this, by the way. It's just never going to happen. We're not rewinding it. Keys are not too bad. I think you'd struggle. I mean, obviously, I've got bigger and older. If I was a kid, I'd probably be able, me and my mates would be able to fit on the keyboard for this, but it's not too bad. Not a bad struggle at all, to be honest with you. It might struggle a wee bit to get on, but... You found a treasure room. Yes! Collect as much treasure as you can. 24 seconds. Oh, I've missed that one. Get that one. Bonuses. Bonus. I hope I don't die in the treasure room, though, because my health's counting down. Faster than the clock, actually. I've just noticed. There we go. Treasure. Oh, do I have to get out within a certain length of time? Look, this time's running out. Do I die? No, I'm going out before the treasure thing runs out. Oh, that's a good bonus. Level 10, find the potion. Ooh, look at that! Graphics changed. I've got some kind of special thing there. Ah, I'm getting totally killed there. That thing there is impossible to kill. And my health's really low. It's going to go badly, you can see. What a great game, though. Must find a copy of Gauntlet 2. That's a great game. Really like that. Got to rewind to start the tape again, because that's how you start all over again. Got to go back to the beginning. No, that's really good. Shall we see if there's anything else on here? Let's have a quick look. I don't think there will be anything else on this tape. So let's give it a quick fast forward while we're getting the load run. Because there'll be quite a lot of levels, I would think. Right, the sound there. Let's whiz on. Okay, on we go.
Here we are.
I think it's...
Nah, it's just levels for it.
It's not going to be anything else other than Gauntlet 2 on here, I don't think. Here we go, we're going to try again.
Nah, Gauntlet 2 levels. Right, okay, well, we'll do a rewind. What we're going to do now, so we're going to get this other tape in. We've got the C90. I did say it was going to be a short one in that sense, because I kind of guessed from the fact that this is from a collection of, from a person who quite regularly
didn't put more than one game on a C90. C90 of all things, God. Think of all the games you could get on there. Number of 16K games you could have got on there, which is unbelievable. I'm sure my friends had compilations with like 20 plus games on it. Really was easy to get lots of them on there. I mean, what, an average of 3 minutes a piece, and each side is 45 minutes. Good grief. Got to do the maths on that, but there we go. Yeah, that's a lot of stuff there. So, we got the Audio Gold International, the Cortec Context one. Context? Yeah, Contec. Contec, that's it. Contec. Right, here we go. We've got music. We've got music, hang on. We've got 80s, 90s music, hang on. Get the tape recorder out. Got that there. Let's give it a blast, see what we've got. Ooh. Ooh. Proper 80s. Can't play too much of it because otherwise we get into trouble with YouTube. Does anybody recognise it? I'm gonna fast forward a bit. Anybody recognise it? We'll see if anybody says. Recognisable? I feel like I should know it. Proper synthesized stuff, isn't it? Still the same sort of thing we've eaten quite a few times, so let's see, fast forward a bit further. Wonder what else is on here now that I've not got that. That's a hell of a tune. Going on and on. Do you remember when we used to go to the, you know, when you were a kid and you went to the old music store with your parents, you know, and they wanted you to force you to play the piano or something like that. Well, maybe in my case, but you know, and then they'd stand you in front of a Yamaha and the bloke would like push the buttons and it would do the old demo and it would do like, what was that song? Popcorn, was it? Do 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 do, that kind of thing. And that also kind of reminds me of a little bit like that. Okay, that's not it, but you know what I mean. Alright, who's this? Sounds like the Beach Boys or something like that, doesn't it? It's like pure Muzak, isn't it? It's the stuff that you get in the lifts, you know, and then makes you want to commit suicide after about 30 seconds. It's our Buddy Holly song. It does sound like a Buddy Holly song to me. What the heck? How do you know? Was there a lot of instrumentals? I don't remember a lot of instrumentals. I remember a lot of song ones. We're still back on the whatever that is. What else have we got on here? Long songs, that's what we got on here for a start off. Fast forward, fast forward, fast forward. Give him a good fast forward this time around. Tonight, love is in the air. We're fast forwarding through before I sing anymore. You don't want me singing anymore. This is where this particular What's on the Tape gets hit by like 17 copyright claims because of I've played that many songs. I haven't played them for long though, so just give me a break, eh? I haven't played them for long at all. Sounds like it's going slower now. I don't know. I don't know if the batteries are running out in my tape player. I'm walking away, I'm fast forwarding. Just leave me alone. Valentine. The thing is, I know some of the songs, some of the words to these things, I have no idea what the songs are called. Halloween. Not a very melodious session, this one. I'm going for it. What else is on there? Come on.
I don't blame him because he run and hid, but the meanest thing that he ever did was before he left, he went and named me Sue. Well,
sounds like this one's live.
Quite a joke, and it got a lot of laughs from lots of folks. Seems I had to fight my whole life through. Some gal would giggle and I'd get red, and some guy'd laugh and I'd bust his head. I'll tell you, life ain't easy for a boy named Sue.
A boy named Sue. Oh dear. Poor, we're back with Sue. I've always wondered what. I've always wondered though if I've ever found an original something else, you know what I mean? Sort of an original song as well, you know, like we've found programs that people have partially written, things that we've kind of rescued from the whole thing, so. Oh.
Aeroplanes tied up with strings.
Grandad. Was it 60s or 70s? Or even 50s, maybe. We're on to full. This is tell you what. This tape's full. That doesn't sound right, though. Does that sound like a cover band? Sound right at all, does it? That doesn't sound right at all. I'm going to get hit by the Michael Jackson, whatever it is, because I think he owns the Beatles, doesn't he? He owns the songs to the Beatles, or his estate does. Now we're up to Little Donkeys. Really? Okay, so is that a Christmas song or is it not a Christmas song? I thought it was a Christmas song. This is packed. I've got the end of that one, whatever that was. What we got now? We got any more? Very romantic, whatever it is. We got Elvis, I think. I'm not very good with music, you know. It's one of these funny things. It's like, I like music, but I've got what I would call a very eclectic taste. I listen to absolutely anything. Don't always like it, but I'll listen to anything. It's a bit like listening to that. It doesn't, none of it bothers me particularly. I don't go, oh, I hate that. But let's see what we've got here. Do, 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 do. And what the heck's that?
I'm fast forwarding it a bit because I reckon it's the intro. No, that's a very long intro. Let's fast forward a bit more. Well, it's hardly the top 40, is it? It's not what I was half expecting from it. I guess we did make mixtapes, didn't we? This particular one doesn't have any detail whatsoever about what's on it or what's in it. I feel like, what was that program with the vets? The Heriots, wasn't it? It was based on a book. That was kind of, I felt like there a little bit. Felt like I was out in the field somewhere. Now we'll see what the next one is. A little bit more beat now. Right, I think we can give that. Well, that's it. I think that's enough of that tape. I think we're going to move on. We're going to move on to some Spectrum, all right? We've done enough of that tape. We're going to move on to the Mega Tape with the Czar Jazz Mega Game, whatever the hell that is. Don't even remember it. Not a game I remember. All right, release. Go for it. Let's go for it. Let's load this game. It's got Pokes after it, and that's got an exclusive 19 from Cascade. Now, was that? I'm thinking of the game, the one Vietnam game. Was that called 19 as well? I'm not entirely sure whether it was or it wasn't. It feels like it should be. Czar Jazz. Sounds very magical. Goes in the Z's. Sinclair user. Oh, they don't do very... Did they do very good intro? I don't remember them doing very good screenshots. Armed to the teeth, Sinclair user. Tape 1. This is the very first one. I believe it was 1989 when these things started. Or 1980. No, it would be earlier than that. 88? In 87. When these things started to appear. One of the two. The bear's awesome, though. You've got to give the bear a credit for being awesome. Arm to the teeth. Is he a panda? No, he's not a panda because he's got black eyes, is he? Does he get the black eyes in the pandas? Yeah, they have. It's just a banzai bear. Oh, look, we're loading two screens because one screen's not enough. We need another. We've done nothing worse. We need two screens. Who's this by then? I think this is 1988, this one. If this is their first tape, and let's just say this, they released this, it must be 88 that they started doing cover tapes. If this is the first mega tape. There's a loading bar there. Looks like a shoot 'em up. Oh, I'm looking forward to this. 1001 Limited. Maybe it was a bit early. No. Loading zero. Or are they just loading dots? They're the biggest dots ever in the world. They're huge. Just massive. So Jay Pickford and P. Garrettside. Yeah. Okay. 1001. Were they a company that ran for a while? I don't think I've got any games by them if they did. However, to be fair, if you look up at the games that are available on Spectrum, it's somewhere in excess of 15,000 games were ever published officially. And that doesn't include the ones where people just flogged them, you know, they made their own covers and flogged them in the markets. There must be tons and tons of those. Homebrew market. And that's the other thing, you see. There. When we come back to this thing where we're talking about the Spectrum and the early 8-bit machines, they really opened up the market for the homebrew game. The volume of games wouldn't have existed if they weren't so easy to develop at home on your computer doing whatever else it is. And this comes back to, as well, the enjoyment that goes with that. What do kids nowadays actually... I mean, I've got some of my own. Do kids nowadays write games? I mean, I used to write games in my bedroom. I used to write them all the time. I used to have friends of mine had this dream of sort of travelling Europe in a custom bus, and it sounds silly now, but I plotted out the entire design of the vehicle, and we did all kinds of stuff on the computer, and we all passed it around the code for that in BASIC, and it was
And it was kind of cool. It was really cool. Number six. I'm going to change my keys first. So I want up, down, left, right, fire. I'm assuming it's a shoot 'em up. But yeah, we used to do that a lot. I don't think kids nowadays quite do that. Binary design. Ah, it is a shoot 'em up. Ah, that's tough. Have I played this before? It seems vaguely reminiscent. Big sprites though going on. Lots of stuff on the screen here. Sadly, they've gone with the old monochrome rather than trying to attempt something, which is all right. I've got my energy bar on the side of the screen, which obviously goes down as I shoot these things. There's obviously points to be had by shooting them. Low points, not a lot of points. You could probably avoid most of this. The ship moves nicely. The animation's good. I don't remember at the time. I don't know. The thing is, I went between the cover. You know when the magazine started giving away cover magazine games, you basically went between them. You never stuck to one or the other, did you? You kind of went with the one that you fancied the most because they didn't often have enough pocket money to buy more than the one magazine. So you would choose the one that had what would be the best offering. So you'd have it open in the shop, you know, you'd look at the instructions and see whether or not. I don't think this does anything, by the way. I played that for a bit there. And I think it's just a high score game. Yeah. A Kamikaze Bear it is. John Pickford lies. Steve Pickford, right? Demon. We'll see. Yeah. But you'd pick the best one, wouldn't you? You wouldn't just pick the first one that came along. It would be a choice. And I don't remember picking this one up because I don't think this game would have been all right. And I love a good shoot 'em up, but I think that we might have been, you know, if they were doing a sale of something that was a full game that was something that was been released previously, you might have gone for that one instead of, because that looked like a budget title to me. And although very nice loading screen, very, you know, the animations were good. It's not. Wasn't brilliant, was it? Wasn't brilliant. Right, poke loader. I'm only loading the poke loader here because it's often had, as I said, they made an attempt to do some sort of fancy graphics on them. Sometimes, not always. I'm just interested to see what games it pokes. You used to write them yourself, you remember that? You just stop the tape and then you have to press break and then you have to type in the code and the line and all that kind of stuff. It's cool. Jet Set Willy being one that I remember doing so that I got infinite lives. Definitely needed that. Okay, let's have a little poke menu and see what we've got. Number one. We've got Terror Balls, Mad Balls, Phantom Club, Ace 2, and Nebulous. I would have hated Nebulous all this time ago. Info. Infinite lives and infinite time. That would have been a cool one, that. Let's see what Terra Max is. Out of interest. This is a funny old game, so this poke gives you unlimited lives, and most of them are unlimited lives, if I'm honest. The thing you really wanted was invincibility, because, you know, infinite lives would maybe get you through the game, but some bits are tough. You won't die when you rear off playing the playing area. Very useful. All right, fair enough. Phantom Club. This, I recognise the name. This. Infinite Energy Supply. This, I'm sure, was an isometric game that I played not that long ago. I remember that. Aces 2. I loved Ace 1. Come on, Biggles. Get those goggles on, because we're going to procure Paler 1, Infinite Planes. Yeah. And Nebulous, we've already done. That's cool. Like that. And Q to quit this many, by the way, does nothing. Not surprised. Right, let's see what this demo is. I had quite a good session actually here. I've had a random conversation about my feelings on the ZX Spectrum Next. We've had some music, courtesy of whatever tape that was, the Context one. And we have had. I'm going to try it in loader mode, see if it's a 128K demo. We've had Gauntlet, We've had California Games, which cut itself short for some reason after the Hacky Sacks, which was quite cool. I quite enjoyed that. And then we played Gauntlet, which we'd really enjoyed. And now we're on to the last of this tape. And I'm not entirely sure what this is. This is either I don't know whether it's a sort of Vietnam game or not. It could be. We'll see. 19. Yeah, it's called 19. I hope it's not whatever it was, Cascade's 19th program, because let's be honest, Cascade's 19th program is probably rubbish, because they were all basic, they were all written basic, which meant they could transfer them between everything else, and it was all mail order, wasn't it? It was £7.95, and you got a tape of 50. Now, I can't remember if I had bought my mail order. I probably did, because I was quite into postal orders, very into postal orders, and I wish my parents hadn't put the things up to car boot sale years ago, but hey, you know, you don't live and learn. But I had a lot of postal order sort of add-ons that you'd only have got from postal orders, and those games probably quite valuable at this stage, you know, highly sought after. But anyway, Cascade was one of those games. I do remember buying it. Most people had Cascade, and when I saw it through my collection the other day, I was expecting to find like a dozen of them, because I do buy bundles quite frequently. Found two, which I thought was quite a surprise, really. I didn't think that any more than sort of... If I'd found more than two, I'd have been quite surprised, really. Wouldn't have been surprised if I found more than two. So, stop the tape. Okay, I've stopped the tape. Coming soon, Frightmare. Ooh! That rings a bell. Frightmare. Enemies of the Darkness Shall Follow. Taraz. Breakout into a New Generation. Cascade Games. Sinclair user, 19. Okay. A Spectrum program broken by Paul Laidlaw. Okay. Graphics by Damon Redmond and Sean Conrad. Conran, sorry. Paul Hardcastle is. It's the Vietnam game. Original music, Paul Hardcastle. This is the 19. The average age of a combat soldier in Vietnam was 19. Unlike the Second World War, it was something like 26 instead. It was different in so many ways. Those who did the fighting, yeah. It's going to do the song now. In World War II, yeah, there you go. The average age of combat soldier, 26. Whoa! Vietnam, it was 19. How good am I remembering that? I'm quite impressed by myself for that. Oh, press play on the tape. Didn't do the music, though. I was expecting it to do 19. No, 19. And then it does this bit where the ladies sing, and it's like... and I can't remember the words, so that was kind of the sound. And that's probably the worst part of the song, to be honest with you. It was more of a... Was it a rap? Was it a political statement? And you never really understood with the Vietnam 19 song. It never made sense to me, that. I might actually have a copy of the full version of this somewhere. Don't think I've ever played it. I remember having it on a mixtape of some sort, and I wasn't very keen on it, to be honest with you. I think because it's an emotive subject, you know, it's talking about soldiers and sort of wars and whatever else is, and it seemed more of a political message than necessarily a song, which I've got no problem with, because of many songs along the way, and books and comics and things like that, I often have political messages. It was just one of those things, and I think at the age when I got this, and I remember, I think it appeared on a tape that I had when I got Operation Wolf for the first time, because I got some sort of mixtapes and whatever else is. I didn't really know what to do with it. I listened to it, and I think I've got it, still got it on some 80s mix somewhere, CD mix somewhere, and I still don't know what to do with it, in the sense of, you know, how you're meant to feel about it. I mean, it spends a lot of time sort of going over the history of the sort of the various things, you know, the combat age, soldiers and all this kind of stuff, but I don't know. Not sure how I'm meant to feel about that. Maybe I'm meant to feel nothing and just listen to the music, but at the same time, it had some messages in there. I mean, to be fair, though, I mean, think about most music, you've got some kind of message, isn't it, you know? Either loving something or you know, dancing or something, I don't know. I'm trying to think of songs now that are in my car. The only thing I can think of is I was listening to Belinda Carlisle the other day. That was Ooh Baby Heavenest on Earth. It's been a very musical what's on the tape from me. I am obviously trying out for one of those, you know, what is it? What do they call them? Britain's Got X Factor or something like that. That's the one. Or is it X Factor Britain? Britain X? I don't know. One of those two. Clearly, I have the voice for it and really don't care about reality TV. Oh dear. I don't care about reality TV. I don't, honestly. No interest whatsoever. Used to, years ago. Used to like it when it was boring. You know, remember reality TV wasn't boring and they hadn't have to sort of cajole the contestants to do anything? It was way back in those times when the initial Big Brothers came out. I mean, the really, really, really early ones. And you know, the first sort of couple of episodes of that, where they basically sat around doing nothing and they just used to give them alcohol and they used to spend all the time sleeping. And it's like, it's almost like watching security cameras, you know, but crapper. You know, spend all day watching security. Oh, look, they've moved again. They've gone to sit in the pool. Look, we've given them some alcohol, so they're going to get drunk. Yeah. It's like a crap prison as well, I suppose. Well, maybe a better prison. I don't know. But either way, I just... those are the days. I didn't mind reality TV when it was like that, because there's no... You know, I mean, it must have been nightmarish for when... Because it was Channel 4, wasn't it, when they had the original Big Brother? Nightmarish for Channel 4 to actually find anything to do, if that makes sense. They were kind of... you know, they had, like... show reels in the evening, you know, and I think you could watch them all day as well, couldn't you? But they had like show reels in the evening, and it's just hilarious. Can you imagine that? They would spend all evening sort of trying to cut it together to make actually a half an hour show, but never mind. Right, 19, boot camp, shooting range. Oh, right, so I'm going to be. Oh, it's playing the music. I've shot him. Oh, she's really hard. That was terrible. The demo section of this game. Still to come, obstacle course. Was that it? All that loading just for that part? That was it, honestly. That entire shooting range. I'm shooting these guys now. Reloading. I'm shooting the dog. I feel a bit cheated? All that loading just for that little section there. Wow. Oh well. I'm not even sure that's the tune, you know. Playing in the background there. You get £2 off it if you send them a postal order. Oh, postal order's great stuff. Check out a postal order of £7.50, £90.95. Saving you some money. It's Harrogate. It's where Cascade Games were. Did you know that? I didn't know Cascade Games were in Harrogate. Just round the corner from, well, around the corner from me down there. Not too far away from me in the long run. 2 weeks before the official launch date. So you even get it 2 weeks early. So they're getting the juices and the hype running with 19. But after that particular intro demo there, I wouldn't buy it. I can't recommend that less, because that was just too hard for what it was. Very hard to see down the gun. Very hard to see where it was. I mean, it would have been nice if there was a sight. Was there a sight on the ground? Let's have a look at this. Is there a sight that gives you a representation? No, there isn't. So you just got your sight for your sniper rifle. And they've inverted the up and down on it. Yeah, shot her. Yeah, can't recommend that at all, really, can you? You know, it's maybe alright when you get on the next place and the obstacle course and then do the full combat zone and all this kind of stuff. The full 19 title page music. Ooh, sampled speech, joystick, free poster. Jeep training. If it was for real, he would be more impressive, wouldn't it? Yeah. 19. Anyway, I'm going to leave you with reality TV, as in watching me. That was full-on reality TV, wasn't it? You've had music, we've had laughs, we've had songs, we've had some serious moments, and I'm going to leave you at that. Anyway, I've been your host, Real Genetic Demon. Thank you for watching. Please feel free to like and subscribe. I'll see you in the next video. Bye-bye.